Hello students, welcome to the class of social study. Let's get started. Little time we have to give for study now today. We are going to do chapter 4, the first cities. We are going to continue it. We have already done this chapter yesterday. What we had done, do you remember what are the things we learned in this chapter yesterday? We had learnt about that Indus Valley civilization was found by two people. Harappa was found by whom? Harappa was found by Rai Bahadur Dayaram Sahani 1921, and Mohenjo-daro was found by R.D. Banerjee. Okay, discovered. Then there were thousands places discovered. Out of 100 were excavated, and in those the largest one cities were Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Alright, then town planning we saw is well planned. They had good drainage system, good houses were made, nice streets were made, broad, straight, cutting each other at right angle. And we saw the great bath, which was used on festive occasion, and there were steps to get into the pool. There were rooms around the pool. Granary, a storage to store the food so that they could use in the tough times. So today we shall start with life of people. Okay, what kind of life the people lived? From the early time till the cities developed, the main demand of people, or people lived for food, shelter, clothing. Now also, but today we want more comfortable. Not only we are not satisfied with food, shelter and clothing, we want more comfortable life. We have become more of materialistic. But at that time people were more to fulfill their need of food, shelter and clothing. Okay, so we go to page number 29. Heading is life of the people. The life of people essentially revolved around food, water, clothing, shelter and security, to be safe. These have been the main concern of humans since the very long time, even they were cave dwellers. So from the time when they were living in the cave and till he developed to live near the cities, his main concern was food, shelter and clothes and safety. Okay, so the civilization around, now second paragraph, the civilization around the same time as the Harappa era along Indus Valley demonstrate the urbanization of cities. So urbanization of cities means the towns were turning into cities. So at that time also the main demand of people was food, shelter, clothing and security. Growth of population at the settlements would have taken place at a great pace. So that time population was also growing very fast. And it is understandable that the people who grew food crops managed to grow enough crop for more than their own needs. So it is understood when they saw the population is growing, and the people living at that time during Indus Valley civilization, they used to grow crop more than they needed so that they could store it for the maybe flood time or drought time or any other difficulty time. So they were growing the crop more than they needed, which is said in this paragraph. You can understand. Thus leaving the, we go to the page 30, other free to take on the associated work like making tools, building houses, other structure part, working as laborers and traders and so on. So people, those who were engaged in agriculture, they cultivated the food surplus more than they needed so that the other people were involved in other activities. They were as they used to be builders, craftsmen, tool makers, building makers, laborers, traders, these were. So with the growing of crop, they did other occupation also. So this was the life of people. Understood? Life of people was around food, shelter. Shelter means home, clothing and safety. All this was their main need. And he did cultivation, that means he did agriculture to fulfill the agriculture and other occupation. Other occupation was, as we can say, painter or building maker, we can say laborer, okay. Some more examples are also there. So there were lots of other occupation also. Understood? So this is about the life of people, centered around this. Next you have, look at your book, what is your next heading? While seeing this class, you also have to look at your book and paragraph. The next heading you have, governance, administration, governance. So governance is, did what kind of administration they have. So in the paragraph it is said, no specific findings have been found to confirm about any ruler in this period. Excuse me. Next heading you have governance. So governance is what? Administration. Which ruler was ruling? So at this time, no findings have been found which ruler was ruling at this period. However, there are some signs that they were governed by a very systematic administration. So when the excavation was done, they found the buildings and all, they found the citadel. You remember citadel, a high place where the assembly hall is there, where great granary is there, where they are storing the grain, where the ruling class lived and where there is great bath. So that structure of the citadel shows, yeah, there were no rulers, but certainly there was some administration which was looking after all the administrative work, that everything runs smoothly by some administrative people. So there, the historians believe, okay, that there may be somebody like as a headman, okay, maybe in the city there must be some headman who will take decisions on issues of all type, including sharing space and conflicts among people. So among in the city there was one headman who will see all the conflicts. You know what is conflict? Conflict is a little fights between people, jhagda ho jana, something related to the land issue, home issues, okay. And sharing of space, who will take which land, whose land is that, whose house is that. All that issues were dealt by a headman. They must have devised a system of securing their area from any outsider by way of uniting among themselves and fighting off anyone from outside the community. So historians also believe that these administrative people or the people who were governing there, they also must have made a security so that nobody outsider attacks on them for their cities. Okay, so that is what said in this line. They must have devised a system of securing area from any outsider by way of uniting themselves. They must have united themselves, formed the governance so that nobody from outside is attacking them. Okay, and also they believe they must have kept an army. Probably they must have had an army, okay, who was led by somebody to protect their city. So form an army which was probably led by someone who ultimately became the protector and ruler. So there must have been an army it is believed by the historians that there must have been an army, and whoever led the army and guide the army, that particular was the ruler or was the protector of the city. Okay, in the book you have next heading, farming and cattle herding. Farming and cattle rearing. Rearing means cattle herding. I have written here rearing. The rearing is also same word. We can write here herding. Herding is looking after animals. Farming and cattle herding. So farming and cattle herding remained the principal occupation of the people. So if you read the paragraph, we go to the book. Quick revision reading of the paragraph, you also do in the book. They started to grow crops and had enough surplus so as to store them for the future. So that means whatever evidences have been found, it shows the main occupation of the people in Indus Valley civilization was doing farming, agriculture and looking after the animals. Okay, that was the main occupation. And how do we know? They have found in Indus Valley civilization when excavation was done, the archaeologists have found some plows, they have found sickles, they have found remains of grains. So in Hindi also I can tell you the plow means like hull, fawada which you say, which is used for digging the ground. Sickle is which is used for cutting the crop. You say in your language hasua. And then grains, anaj ke dane bhi unhe mile hain. That means they have found the grains, they have found sickle, they have found plowshares. Plow, that means it shows that people were doing agriculture and the crops were wheat, barley, maize, okay, millets, cotton. These are the crops they were growing. Okay, and in the first paragraph also we know that they were growing the crop so much there was surplus. They used to grow the crop more than that they needed. So that extra they were cultivating and storing so that they could use it in the time of flood or any disaster if they face. Okay. Next you have in the second paragraph, there is evidence that the people of the Indus Valley civilization had developed the art of taming and rearing cattle. So they also have found some evidences which shows that people at that time were rearing the cattle, animals, okay. Which animal? Goat, sheep, dog and pigs. These animals' remains have been found in Indus Valley civilization. So the archaeologists believe that these are the animals they were taming, okay. And they have not found any of the remain of the horse, okay. So it means Indus Valley people were not taming the horse, okay. So this is about farming and cattle herding. Doing agriculture, how we know? We have the proof of plows, sickles and grains, which are the crops they were cultivating. Wheat, barley, maize, cotton, millets. Cattle rearing, they used to look after dog, sheep, goat and pigs. They had no idea of horses as no evidences have been found. Next you have pottery. Next heading you have pottery. In pottery, pottery of different shapes and sizes and designs have been unearthed from these sites. So they have found pottery, okay, different shapes, designs, sizes, pottery they have found, okay, and they are made up of mud, okay, earth, okay, earthenware which you say. And it shows that the people at that time were very mastered in the skill of making pottery. And how the earthenware have been decorated with geometric and figurative designs. So whatever what you say the pots, we can say they have found, it is well colored, well designed, well shaped. And there is a painting and some designs, geometric designs are made, some shapes, some lines, some figures are drawn on the pots, okay. So they were first glazed in heat and were then extensively used. So the pottery is that the people were well skilled in making pot, coloring it, painting it, giving it different shapes and sizes and painting with some geometrical shapes and some figures on it. So that was the pottery. Well skilled people even at that time. Next you have got craftsmen. Okay, next heading is craftsmen. So craftsmen, artwork on the pots and many other items made of wheat, stones, metals have variety of colors and texture which convey that the craftsmen were quite good, well skilled. So craftsmen at that time were very, very skilled people. How we know? Because lot of pots have been found. They are made up of beads, stones, metals and मुझे हंसी आ रही है पीतल की आवाज से. Next you have pottery. So pottery, there are craftsmen. They have found the skill. What we say, the excavation. They found lots of evidences of lots of beads, stones, metals, variety of colors and texture, which convey the craftsmen were quite good and well skilled. So when excavation was done, pots are found. Okay, and many other items. Not only pots. Some other items are also made up of beads, metals, stones. Okay, this shows how skillful the craftsmen were at that time. Okay, this was about the craftsmen. They also have found a pot which is a pottery made up of terracotta, has a reddish color with design in black. So they have found different types of, when excavation was done, they found lot of pots and different, what we say, the earthenware, which shows the skill of the craftsmen at that time. Next you have jewelry. Jewelry is what they used to wear, bangles. They have found, the archaeologists have found some bangles, some earrings, some rings, some anklets, okay, some amulets. Which is made up of gold, silver, bronze, terracotta. So it shows how skillful people were, and also they had the knowledge of these metal. They were knowing about the gold, they were knowing about the bronze or silver or the terracotta. Okay, so people had knowledge of wearing the ornaments also. Okay, next you have toys. Toys are found which are made up of only mud. मिट्टी के खिलौने होते थे. Like you have now so many variety of toys and electronic toys and so much technology has advanced. But at that time, children used to play with the mud toys. And the toys were of some carts, okay, some bulls, some elephants, which you can see in the picture also is shown you in the book here. Na? Toys, they are shown here. So some toys were like variety of dolls, plows, cart. These were the things made and given to the children to play. And these are also found in excavation. Then only the scientists have concluded the children must be playing with the toys made up of mud. Okay. So we conclude with these today. And we will continue with the religious belief and cloth making and seals. I have left cloth making, religious belief, seals and other things which we will continue tomorrow. Okay, and I hope you have understood the chapter farming and cattle rearing, or we can say herding, pottery, craftsmen, jewelry, toys. Okay, in jewelry and toys, cloth making, people used to wear cotton clothes. How we know? Because when excavation was done, the people have found needles, spindles, some cloth pieces, all that shows the people were using that. Okay, so we conclude with this today. We'll continue tomorrow. Read the chapter once again, and especially read Do You Know Boxes or Around the World. These you read yourself, okay, and keywords. Okay, thank you. We'll meet tomorrow.